Hello friends, today we discuss about the wind erosion. In this we will discuss all these topics one by one. Wind erosion. In India, every year millions of topsoil lost by the soil erosion. The soil erosion is the process of detachment, transportation, deposition of soil by the agents. The soil erosion leads in decreasing the soil quality, reduce the crop production. The sediment moves in the reservoir, as a result its storage capacity is reduced, and this sediment causes the pollution in streams, rivers or any other water bodies. In agriculture aspect, the soil erosion is removes the topmost fertile soil and subsequently removes the subsoil layers, and it becomes unproductive land. It changes the soil structure and organic matter. As a result, the crop productivity is reduced. The soil erosion is mainly caused by two agents. One is your water and second one is wind. In water erosion, each and every individual raindrop hits the land surface with massive force up to the 50 km per hour and detach the soil in form of splash erosion. The splash erosion is greatly effect on slopy land as compared to the uniform in shape, whereas the wind erosion is the fine soil particle get detached and eroded by the wind speed. As the wind speed increases double, the larger amount of soil picked off from the soil surface, and even the soil erosion may double or triples. Suppose if wind velocity increases from 30 km to 40 km per hour, then the wind erosion may doubles. So the main causes of wind erosion are changing its land cover by the deforestation, forest firing, overgrazing, and improper agricultural practices such as shifting cultivation, mining, keeping the land barren. So the most favorable condition or wind erosion mainly occur in your arid and semi-arid region and very less in your humid regions. Let factor affecting the wind erosion. So those factors are climate factors and soil factors, vegetation factor. Where the climate factor, in the precipitation in arid and semi-arid region, there is a less rainfall. In this condition, there is a more erosion. In soil factors such as soil texture, structure and density of particle, organic matter plays major role in your soil erosion. You know that in a sandy soil, the higher erosion takes. Vegetation also influence the soil erosion directly. Vegetation, in this condition, there is a less chance of erosion as compared to the soil is directly exposed to the wind erosion. Also, the slope or wind direction plays a major role. If the wind direction in this direction with respect to slope, so the windward direction, the higher erosion as compared to your leeward side. Mechanics of wind erosion. Similarly, overall occurrence of wind erosion could be described in the three phases. That is our initial movement, or we call that is your detachment of your soil particle by the wind erosion or high wind velocity. And the detached particle may transport in the different forms and takes deposition where the wind velocity may reduce. So now the initial movement of the soil particle takes place by the wind force on occurring on your ground surface. The wind force which occurring on ground surface, we can call that is your threshold velocity. Threshold velocity nothing but the velocity which required to move the soil particle from one place to another place. We call that is the threshold velocity. And next one is your transportation. Means the particle may move from one place to another place in the three major process. One is your suspension, saltation, surface creep. After that, the soil may deposit where the velocity may reduce, and when the gravitational force is greater than the force holding particle in air, it could be occur when velocity decreases. due to the surface obstruction or any other normal causes. Let us discuss about the transportation and how their three phases may occur in different condition with respect to different particle sizes. So now, the suspension occurs when the very small or fine particle, the size less than your 0.1 mm, are lifted in atmosphere or in air by the wind and carried over the long and high distance. See here, the very fine particle, due to the wind velocity, it is lifting in your air and carrying very long height and may also transport for a longer distance. This is called your suspension. So it is found by the laboratory that 3 to 38% of soil weight may be transported through your suspension process. Whereas in saltation, the movement of medium sized particle, the range between your 0.05 mm to 5 mm in the by the series of low bounces or hoop along the surface. So it is the most effective among all these three processes. Okay, because there is a large amount of soil loss in this saltation, about the 50%, that is the 55 to 72% of total soil particle may loss through the saltation mechanism. And here the most vulnerable particle range, that is your 0.1 to 0.15 mm in diameter. So we can see here the soil particle which are larger in size, means greater than the suspension and less than your creep, may transport in the series of low bounces. Surface creep, or it also called your Venturi effect. So that is the large particle, means the particle are larger than saltation particle size, that is your 0.5 to 2 mm, are too heavy and these are moved by the rolling action of your ground surface due to their wind velocity. Loss of particle in this surface creep is about 7 to 25% in this mechanism. Quantity of soil has been moved depend on your soil particle and gradation of soil and wind velocity, that can be given by the Hudson, that soil quantity moved is directly proportional to wind velocity and minimum wind velocity, that is called your threshold velocity, power of 3 and square root of particle diameter. Similarly, we will estimate the soil erosion due to the wind. That is similar like your universal soil loss equation, A is equal to RKLSCP. Similarly, in this way, we also estimate the wind erosion by this equation. See the wind erosion and control measure. The principal measure to control the wind erosion are broadly classified into two major groups. So here our target is the reduce the surface wind velocity and to increase the soil characteristics. So let us see the how we will control the surface wind velocity. Those are by three methods. One is the vegetative method, tillage method, tillage practice, or mechanical or structural measures. So in vegetative measure, this adapted based on your severe condition of your wind erosion. So in temporary measures and permanent measure. In temporary measure, the crop management practices are followed. Those are good vegetative cover on your soil surface. These practices include the growing the crop, such as more effective for erosion control than interalien crops. The effectiveness of the crop to the control erosion depends on stage of growth, density cover, row direction, width of crop and kind of crop and the climate condition. And next one is your permanent vegetative measures. The permanent vegetative measures are planting the trees, shrubs and grasses. Those are broadly divided into your windbreak and shelter belts. Windbreak means the any type barrier, either mechanical or vegetative, used for protecting the areas like building apartments, orchards or farmstead from your blowing wind. Windbreak are normally constructed by one row or maximum up to two rows across your direction of wind prevailing. The windbreak act as fencing wall around the affected areas. So shelter belt. Shelter belt is the simple longer barrier than windbreaks, and it raised by more than two rows, usually at right angle to direction of prevailing wind. And the rows of shelter belt can be developed by using the shrubs and trees. The shelter belts are more effective for reducing the impact of wind as compared to your windbreak. So now see here, this is our wind direction and we are planting the trees. So in this condition, the direction of the wind has been changed. So the area which has been, suppose let us see, this is your wind direction. So this is my crop grown area. So in this condition, very smaller in size and little medium and higher plant. This is my area which has been protected from wind. Windbreaks are mainly used for the conservation of soil moisture and to protect the crops. And it also reduces the evaporation. Wind particles are moving. So here are trees. So this is one row and smaller row and another row. So in this condition, wind direction may be increases the crop area. Similarly, the another example, the rows of trees has planted. So these are the along the wind direction, also across your wind direction, the two type of protection of windbreak and shelter belts has been planted. Similarly, here and here, the combination of your buildings, apartments and your trees. Similarly, here protection of field, the U shape of windbreak has been planted. The tillage practice such as ploughing are, so these are the primary tillage, secondary tillage and the use of crop residues and strip cropping also adopted in the tillage practices. The mechanical measures are permanent vegetative measures. These are method consist of mechanical obstructions are constructed across the prevailing wind to reduce the impact of blowing wind on the surface. This obstruction may fencing the wall, stone packing, etc. Mean the construction of your stones or any other walls. The area protection from windbreak or shelter belt. So that depends upon your, so that mainly depends upon your height of the plant, height of the your windbreak. So here is the area which has been protected. So now it is the simple, this is the height of your plant we can take. So now this is a hedge and the minimum velocity, wind velocity, and the actual wind velocity at height of 15 meter. Suppose the plant height is 15 meter, what is the actual velocity at this condition at 15 meter height, and this is the minimum wind velocity at the height of 15 meter required to move the most aerodable soil particle, and theta is the angle of deviation of prevailing wind direction from perpendicular to the wind. So now wind, a direction of wind, so in this condition move. So now with respect to horizontal, so what is the angle, this is the theta, and h is a height of your barrier or windbreak or shelter bed, erosion protecting your agriculture land. So now here suppose this is the height of the plant in 36 meters. So in this condition, the prevailing wind direction, how the wind velocity has been reducing. So suppose here the wind velocity is 40 kilometer per hour. Now this is the wind velocity has been reducing. Here again the 10 to 15 kilometer per hour. Okay, here also see here the 15 to 20 kilometer per hour has been reduced. So this is the simple, the zone of reduced wind velocity downward of barrier. So now here the 50 to 70% may be protected, and here the 25 to 50% of field reduced velocity. Here the up to 70 to 80% velocity has been reduced. And the design prospects of your shelter belts and will break mainly depends on your location, means where you want to construct, where you want to plant the windbreak or shelter bed. That is depends upon your wind velocity and the direction of wind. Suppose in a direction of wind in this direction, so I want to plant across wind direction, that is in unidirection condition. So width, so now this is the my plant. So what is the width? That width may be depends upon your number of rows of plant raised in the shelter belt. So in shelter belt we construct only more than two rows, whereas in windbreak only one or two rows. So length of the shelter belt also depends your wind width of area to be protected and climate condition. And spacing depends on spacing of shelter belt or windbreak is the horizontal distance between the point from the where the protection of the area from a belt begins to the point where the protection of area from the belt ends means, so this is the horizontal distance. This is the horizontal distance where the protection of your land starts and where the protection of area, simple horizontal distance. So now here my protection area, this is, so now this is the horizontal area. The density of shelter bed or windbreak is the spacing between plants in each rows and spacing between the rows. Means suppose this is the my rows, okay, and here the plant, these are the my plant. In this distance mean density, this is the distance, also the distance between the row to row and plant to plant. So this is comes under your density, this is area density, that is the spacing between your row to row and plant to plant. It also called as your permeability of belt or break. So the density may be classified again, fully protection, partially protection and impermeable protection. So these are the major advantages or purpose of the windbreak.